Hey, so I'm playing Elite Dangerous, and I'm back in the bubble again for the first time in a long time. And I decided I haven't been in Seoul, actually, in a long time, even when I was in the bubble. I used to keep all my ships there at Abraham Lincoln. I recently moved them all to pretty close at Van Manen Star. Just down here, which you need a different permit for. So that's not far at all from Seoul. That was like the first permit I bothered to get. I got as far along with the Federation ranking just so I could finally go to Earth. Mainly Earth. It was kind of really annoying. I remember when I first started playing and like, oh, I'm gonna go see Earth, and it's just like, that first Sidewinder, even though it's not that far, right? LHS, how far is that? LHS, three, it's not typing. 3447. Yeah, that's not far at all, right? Well, in a year free Sidewinder that you get day one, I don't even know if you can get, like, you have to go way around or do something stupid. Anyway, so that was like the first couple of weeks at least. My only real goal was to get to Earth in this game.
Frameshift drive charging.
But I haven't been there in ages, so let's go say hi to Earth again. Station. So if you were actually to make Earth your home system, make home, this one right here, Daedalus, which is in orbit of Mercury, this would be a very good choice because it's just right here. Here's Daedalus. Yeah, so you've got Daedalus. Real close to the sun. So if you're hopping in and out of the system, that's a pretty good spot. On Mercury itself. Also is not very clean. from the sun. I think there's an orbital station. Oh, there's a small station. Or no, station. So, we might as good a choice as to take this. But still, not horrible. And then, of course, you've got Earth. There's a couple of stations. There's Abraham Lincoln, there's Gorbachev, the Kingao, is apparently the person that's basically the person who invented the frameshift drive, this game. And over the moon, you've got a station too, Galileo. Galileo, Galileo. Galileo Figaro. No, Galileo Figaro. There should be a Figaro. That'd be hilarious. Have a Figaro station orbiting the moon. Go with Galileo. So let's look at Venus. Like I said, you can land on Mercury. You cannot land on Venus, sadly. And that's also a true statement today for like NASA. This is one of the most inhospitable balls in our vicinity. The Soviets have sent some probes that would occasionally last like, I think one could last maybe a couple hours. It wasn't long. It's a very unfriendly place to be. But it is one of the prettiest of them all. We get this really nice, we're gonna actually drop out. It's just a pretty one. They did a great job rendering this one. Okay.
Frameshift drive charging.
Yeah, there's a small station.
Ready to engage. 4, 3, 2, 1. Engage. So, in the game's lore, it's actually not really anymore. It's kind of, it's really Mars that's supposed to be by that. Like, the capital of the Federation is Mars. There's, like, World War III. That's a realistic distance too. The moon looks big in our sky, but I realize it's so far up there.
Sadly, you can't land on the moon, which is... That kind of pissed me off. All the places I'd like to go. Right there would be cool. And they've done a pretty decent job getting it in here. There we are. So this should put things in perspective. Look at the Earth. So small. Galileo is a pretty nice sight. So yeah, that'd be a really good, nice place to go to. Galileo would be a great station. One of the Earth stations would be a great station. So I was using Abraham Lincoln.
Pleasure to have you at
this Federal Station, Commander. Let's do this. There we go. There's Earth. And the station. Where's the moon? I lost the moon. Where's the station? Where's the moon go? Blind. Ah, there we go. Oh, there you go. You can get Earth and the Moon all together. I'm gonna take a picture of that, actually. That's a good one. You've got the Earth, you've got the Moon, you've got the Orion Nebula, you've got, what's that one, Witch Head's Nebula, you've got Barnard's Loop, various other fun things, Horse Head Nebula.
Station and the moon together.
need to keep on going back. Ask me what's like about the most quintessential space scene. This would probably be it. You got the moon, you got a funny blue and purple spaceship, and you've got a slowly rotating wheel. Yeah. Welcome to the moon. Let's go to Earth.
Brain shift drive charging.
Start the hour.
4, 3, 2, 1, engage.
Stations, there's Gorbachev, and they're all basically in the same circle. Blue dot trailing it, and station in front of the Earth. seconds up. So that is... Oh, here we go. We're in miles now. The Caribbean that well to know what's what. One of you is Cuba. Maybe that one. I don't remember anymore. So yeah, America, right there.
Frameshift drive charging.
Earth. Mars has been terraformed, first unsuccessfully, and then successfully eventually. And that's where all the cool kids live. Mars is the nice part of town. Earth kind of got ruined in the nuclear war, and then everybody had money and moved to Mars. So, welcome to Beverly Hills. Capital of the Federation is on Mars. All the people that have money on Mars. There's a non-human relic found on Mars. The first non-human thing. They're not really getting into details about what it is. So there is Mars High. Six, but you have to pay more attention.
assist on.
First non-human relic was found in space. The object was found buried on Mars. It was no bigger than a child's hand and was still surrounded in secrecy even in 3300 and even in 3306. That was so sad. Has ever been circulated as to the properties of the item or its other origin. Non-human. I don't know why that would be even a secret at this point, right? Because...
Scan detected.
Oh, we see. Mars. Let's put those missing planets. That's going to be Saturn over there. Oh, that's Neptune. But only Jupiter has the high value resource extraction sites. So if you want to mine, or you want to shoot people mining, or you want to shoot people who are shooting people who are mining, Jupiter's where to be. And it's going to be a while. I'm going to pull up the map. So yeah, Mercury, Daedalus, Venus, Burnell station that nobody uses, Earth, all sorts of stations. My favorite, Abe Lincoln and Galileo. Mars High. There's the asteroid belt, which I basically never would get. Jupiter has a couple of its moons that you can land on. Io, you cannot. Columbus. That was the other station. So I was originally hanging out in Abraham Lincoln, and then I moved all my ships to Columbus. And then, did I? No, I did not move to Columbus. That's when I left Earth. Yeah. You might not know this, it's kind of a more recent thing, like a decade or two, but still. Yeah, Jupiter's got rings. Everybody thinks of Saturn and its rings. Those have been known for ages. Neptune's got rings. Uranus has rings. Everybody has rings. Except for us, poor Earth. Rings. There's even one of those little, was it Maki Maki? I think even Maki Maki had, like, a tiny little ring on it. But not in the game. Oh, fun thing about Mars. It doesn't have any moons. They're missing. And I have trouble believing that was an accident. I really do. It's like, oh, we just forgot the moons. It's like, how do you forget the moons of Mars? And there's just no explanation for that. So that's interesting. Jupiter. So there's Callisto. Jupiter's got Callisto. Yeah, so they only do some of the moons, which kind of is annoying. Like, especially with Saturn, I wish they'd have the little tiny shepherd moons. There's Ganymede. Io. Yeah, Columbus is in orbit of Io. Let's go there. Actually, no, let's go to the resource extraction site. There we go. If you spend a lot of time this is in this resource extraction site. Jupiter, yeah. Beautiful. Really nice. Best place to see it from? In the ring. Place to shoot people.
Frame shift drive charging. 4, 3, 2, 1, engage.
Saturn's everybody's favorite ringed planet. Saturn I've had? Triton, that's right. Triton had the weird permit that nobody knows how to get. I don't think anybody knows how to get a Triton permit. Triton is the largest moon in Neptune and the seventh largest in the Sun. It is the coldest moon in the Sun. Voyager 2 recorded a surface temperature of -391 Fahrenheit. Its surface has indicating it is a relatively young moon. It is geologically active with geysers and earthquakes. It was first discovered by William Lessel on 10 October 1846. Just 17 days after Neptune was discovered. Titan is permit locked by the minor faction Mother Gaia. Titan you can land on. Actually, this is a good place to Saturn looks like it's open. That's interesting. Because they don't do that to stars. Anyway, yeah. So Shepherd moons, right? That's something I miss the most. So in the rings, you can see things like, you see that line? Is, but there's the reason why this gap is here is because there's a tiny little moon and it's basically cleared it out. But the moon's not here. And this would, it's a shame because this would be so cool to have, like, especially if you could land on it, right? You know, just hop onto this little moon and you're just like right in the ring. You can, all you can do is try and do this thing. Try and surf. So. fun fact about Uranus. I live in Missouri, and there is a Uranus, Missouri, and they sell fudge. Just saying. Shots. Right. So yeah, Uranus. Also has rings. All of its moons are landable that they have. Only has four of their moons. Ariel, Umbriel, Titania, Oberon. I was like, yeah. The rocks. Stations passed here. That's the last one. So, that's the last place you can reasonably set up as a station is Titan City over Saturn. light seconds. 20,000 light years is 20,000 light seconds is not as long. Faster you can go. So I'm not going to take a direct line. I'm going to head away from Neptune as quickly as possible. Then take the direction of Neptune. Seventh planet from the sun. It's the Greek god of the sky. And not just a juvenile joke. The grandfather of Zeus, the father of Cronus. Was Jupiter and Saturn specifically. And other terminology. So Zeus is Jupiter, Cronus is Saturn, Uranus. Writers use Salus or Salem as a way to express the monotheistic god of Judaism. Juvenal identifies the Jewish god Salus as the highest heaven. Summum Salem. Summum Salem, saying that the Jews worship the moon of the divinity of Salus. Patronus uses a similar language for Moses' passage, describing the Holy of Holies of the Temple Church, exposing a sky.
dark side, but technically done on planets now, aren't I? Oh, Pluto's clutching on Saturn. That's hilarious. Let's go look at Pluto. No. I can land on Chiron, however you say that. Which is its moon that's... Oh, this is another interesting one. We'll have to look at this one. Persephone. Doesn't exist. This is not real. Persephone after Pluto. There's something in orbit of Persephone too, I don't remember what. Let's go to Orrery. So Sedna's real. Makemake is real. Slate is. All these things are real. Voyager. There's other ones. It's a different region for which one that is. There's a Voyager. There's a different region for Voyager. And other things. Finish Pluto. Thank you.
Alright. No, I actually don't remember how accurate their point was. Hey, there's a crash ship on. Seven light days. Ships here go the further you get away from anything gravitating, the faster you go. So I'm at 64.70. Well, I'm not gonna stay up for that long. So anyway, that's a nice little tour of the solar system. If you feel the need, you can grind permits and get soul and take a look for yourself. Maybe set up camp.